Which one do you want?
All right, just about 2 minutes before skate action here on track two at the Big O 2015, where we'll be seeing the local Emerald girls go up against Evergreen in a junior bout to remember.
Yeah, that's right. The Mob City Misfits are going to be playing in green this afternoon.
My name's Pat Trant, and
I'm Professor D, and we're going to be bringing you the action here from beautiful Eugene, Oregon.
Right now they're doing some equipment checks, and we'll be having skate action before you know it.
Number 83, Bomba Grande, Bomba Granite.
Yeah, why don't we start with the rosters here, if you would do the honors with the Emerald City.
Sure. Here we have at 00, that's Death Wish. Number 11, Bashful Babe. Number 12, Tiny Badness. Number 13, Psychotic Angel. Number 14, Gory Gory Hallelujah. Number 16 is going to be Juke Skywalker. Number 23, Gallifrey. Number 27, Lethal Ivy. 314, Speedy Peaches. 33, Slam Shady. 44, Tipsy Tear. 55, Tie Dye. 57, Beautiful Deadly. 615, Little Boom Hangering. Number 83, Bomegranate. And number 99, that's Hydro Jane Bomb. That are your Emerald City Junior Gems Reservoir Dolls.
Well, and I'm not sure that I can get through the whole Mob City Misfits lineup in 16 seconds, so I'm going to go ahead and defer that. Maybe we can grab the first 30 seconds after the first jam here, but I see Bombshell is out there lined up to jam for the Mob City Misfits.
Whilst Emerald City has 00, that's Death Wish, lined up on the line for Eugene. Death Wish already through the pack, and she is your lead jammer.
And we've got Bombshell hot on her heels.
Death Wish calling it off almost immediately, but first grabs 4 points for the All-Stars from Emerald City.
All right, so I'm going to go through these real quick. We've got 000 Moose, 106, you just saw Bombshell, 11 Bellamoy, 12 Justifiable Homicide, number 15 Kieran, number 17 Turbocharged, 18 Candy Camaro, 19 TikTok, 2 Awesome, 23 Afro Jamurai, 24 Aneurysm, 253 Just Daisy, 29 Cayenne Pepper, 34.5 Little Miss Chaos, 46 Izzy X, and 8 Hard Candy.
Right off the bat, Angel finds her way to the aluminum throne. She is in the penalty box right at the whistle. They also lost Speedy Peaches on that second turn.
Turbocharged, the jammer for Mob City, is also going to the box, so that's going to give the Reservoir Dolls a power jam.
Jammer go round begins. And that's Angel grabbing points for the Reservoir Dolls. Having a little trouble on the inside, but undeterred, 5 more for Reservoir Dolls.
Turbocharged back in the, well, I was going to say back in the pack, but he's not. He is back to the penalty box. Turbocharged, the jammer for Mob City, is sitting for another 30 seconds.
Right off the onset, Mob City having a little bit of penalty trouble, enabling Angel to grab 5 more for the locals. Only on the second jam, we're looking at a 19-point difference. A as Bashful Babe, the pivot for Emerald City, finds her way to the penalty box.
Yeah, we're going to have Turbocharge through. He is on his scoring pass there, or was, so he's going to throw 5 points up for Mob City before the end of this jam.
Mob City's first 5 points, but it gets called off before any more traction can be made. Gallifrey, number 2-3, now on the line for Reservoir Dolls.
And Bellamoy jamming for Mob City.
Little discussion between coach and official, slowing down the pace of game just a little bit. Not quite sure what it is so far.
Well, the jams timer is signaling a official timeout. Not certain if they're going to use their review or not. So you can see the officials are out there discussing an issue that was brought up by the Mob City bench staff there. We don't know what it is.
I think it may have something to do with their jammer's trip to the penalty box. Not sure yet.
Okay, so they're calling the outside pack refs in to have a little discussion with them as well to put them in here. Again, still an official timeout, as Mob City has not indicated that they are looking for a review or to use their review, which is definitely possible that the bench staff could bring up an issue that the officials can choose to discuss even without having to use an official review, especially if there isn't a specific call or lack of call that they're looking to have changed or modified in some way. Mob City girls are out there having a little dance in the middle of the track, though.
They're preparing some dance moves.
Yeah, they're pretty excited to be out here playing in this game, obviously.
Everybody's excited to be here at the Big O. An amazing tournament so far. We're in day three, the day where things start to wind down. But everybody's amped up for the U.S. versus the world tonight, where the MVPs from games played here will play against the U.S. team. That'll be an exciting one, and that auditorium will be packed. So early in the game to have such a game stoppage review, but it's necessary sometimes to change up the pace. Not sure if that's what the coach was aiming for or if it's truly an issue out there.
Well, head ref calling the shots is talking to the scorekeepers here. I'm trying to eavesdrop on his conversation. I think it had to do with whether points were given to one of the jammers initially on an initial pass as opposed to a scoring pass. Hopefully we'll get an official clarification here shortly.
Sitting in at 26 minutes left still in this half, and a bit of a difference in score. That's 26-5 in favor of the locals, the Reservoir Dolls. Looks like we might be back to skate action.
Yeah, I don't think any modifications of the score were made. I think there was just a clarification. Maybe the clarification that was made was that everything was done correctly by the refs. And so we see Gallifrey out there against Bellamoy.
Gallifrey making quick action, grabbing that lead jammer status. She will have control of this jam for now.
Bellamoy banging her way through on the outside, ends up getting pushed out of bounds and recycled back almost to the pivot line.
Gallifrey fighting that green wall up front, and they gotta let her go. She grabs 5 for Reservoir Dolls.
Bellamoy up, and she breaks out of the pack on her initial pass.
on a second scoring pass. Gallifrey calls it off in the back of the pack. A smart move before the jammer from the other team could get any traction.
Yeah, held the Misfits to 0 points on that jam. And I see that we've got out there Allsome. He's jamming for Mob City.
Well, that's Tipsy Terror out there for Reservoir Dolls.
Ooh, Allsome out in front first, pushing through the line. Can he make it? No, he gets pushed out of bounds on the inside.
His aggressive action did not get him the lead jammer status. That goes to number 44, Tipsy Terror, for the Emerald City Girls.
Both teams are losing blockers to the box.
Reservoir Dolls lose their pivot to the box, and Speedy Peaches as well.
Allsome has also made it out. Both jammers on scoring passes currently.
Both jammers grabbing 4 points, but Tipsy Terror calls it off to slow down the progress of the Mob City.
Mob City was able to put a couple more points there on the board during that jam.
Psychotic Angel back on the line for Reservoir Dolls.
And we're going to see Bombshell out there jamming for Mob City.
Little jam on jam action at the whistle.
Bombshell being pushed out of bounds on the outside.
Bombshell squeegeed to the side and made to recycle.
Bombshell trying to bust her way through. Gets pushed out of bounds. It looks like she might have taken a hit to the nose.
And 1-3, Psychotic Angel is your lead jammer.
Yeah, Bombshell is off the track after an injury to the face. She's taken herself off.
We're going to see if that score achieved by number 1-3 for the Dolls is going to be posted. Pretty sure it is. The officials are checking the floor to make sure there isn't anything that will make someone slip and slide. They bring out the CSI team. Cast of television procedural. Fill in the joke yourself there. I hope everybody's okay.
Yeah, it looks like Bombshell's okay. I can see her up on the sideline. She's just working with the Mob City bench staff. I don't believe the EMTs are involved at this point in time. It looks like she might have taken a little pop to the nose, but she's definitely upright.
Good news. Here comes the floor cleaning staff. Biohazard.
This official timeout is giving the opportunity for both teams to have a little bit of a conference in here. You see the Mob City coach. He's in there talking to his team right now. It's probably a good chance for them to regroup a little bit without actually having to use one of their team timeouts. So it's going to be unfortunate that Bombshell was at least temporarily put out of commission, but probably a good thing so he can get in there and talk to his folks and give them a pep talk and try to adjust strategy a little bit.
Yeah, they might need to pull up the intensity on the inner pack work and shut down those Emerald City jammers.
Yeah, it's definitely been difficult for Mob City thus far in the game to really put together a cohesive defense. The Emerald City Reservoir Dolls have been able to break through. I believe that they've achieved lead in each of the five jams that we've had so far.
Here early on in the game, there's quite a difference in the score. That's 9-44 in favor of Emerald City.
Yeah, with the power jams, Emerald City was able to really get going and throw a lot of points up on the board early on.
Emerald City needs some credit for their defense as well, pushing the Evergreen ladies out to the edge.
Oh yeah, absolutely. It can't be done by offense alone. You have to keep that other jammer back, and then they've done an excellent job.
On most teams, at least.
The entire day, everybody's like.
All right, so the cleanup looks like it is just about to be finished up here.
Timekeeping official still indicating that we're at official timeout as they check the floor for spots.
Yeah, totally. The most creative names in the business.
If it goes as it looks like on the line for the Emerald City, it will be 0-0 Death Wish again.
Yeah, and I see number 253, and that's going to be just Daisy wearing the star, I believe, for the first time for Mob City.
The broom is out. Looks like we're about to get it all clear.
Yeah, not only do they need to get everything cleaned up, but they need to get it dried up as well, too.
Thanks to the staff here at this amazing event.
Yeah, they've done a really great job all weekend.
Back to skate action.
Yeah, the next whistle we hear is going to start the jam. Like I said, just Daisy jamming for Mob City.
Whilst Death Wish, number 00, will be jamming for Emerald City's Reservoir Dolls.
Just Daisy out in the front. Can she break out for a yes? Just Daisy breaks out first, and she has the lead jammer, but hot on her heels is the Emerald City jammer.
Little race the pace, going jammer on jammer up front in the flat.
Evergreen controls the back of the pack before the Emerald City jammer can get there. Just Daisy calls off that jam, 0-0.
Zero gain jam. On the line now is number 4-4. That's Tipsy Terror one more time for the Emerald City girls.
And we've got number 15, Kieran, jamming for Mob City. Both jammers jockeying for position before the whistle starts. Kieran takes the inside line, gets pushed out of bounds.
With a little help from the Emerald City pivot.
Oh, but Kieran is able to break out, and he gets lead jammer for Mob City. Kieran back in the pack. He's got a four wall of Reservoir Dolls up in front. Unable to get through.
Number 4-4, Terror having a hard time with that green wall. They're pumping up the intensity in mid-pack.
The game's definitely gotten defensive as Kieran is able to get a spin move and get around it. We've got a star pass right there by Emerald City. I think that number 23, Gallifrey, accepted the star pass, and she's got it in her hand, and she's trying to slide around. She's going to stick it on there, see if she can force that call off by Kieran.
Gallifrey going from pivot to jammer.
Kieran does call it off, but not in time. 4 points for each team on that pass.
Good strategy there for the Emerald City ladies. Beautiful Deadly now on the line for Reservoir Dolls.
We've got Bella Moy jamming again for Mob City.
That's the whistle.
Oh, that was a beautiful move by Beautiful out there in the front.
She makes it look easy around the right side of the pack. Already on her scoring round.
Yeah, Bella Moy finally is able to push out, and she finished her initial pack. She's coming around to see if she can score. Unfortunately, looks like a beautiful Deadly got a not-so-beautiful back block, and she's going to be heading to the penalty box. Scoring points now is Bella Moy for Mob City.
A possible plot point for this game right here is a power jam for the Mob people.
Yeah, they're going to be able to erase at least some of this deficit before Beautiful Deadly can get out of the penalty box. But their defense is doing pretty good. Bridging now, back one, and Bella Moy with two blockers to beat. Can she do it? No, she gets pushed out of bounds on the inside as Beautiful Deadly gets back on the track.
The recycle held back by the front blockers for Emerald City gives Deadly a chance to go jam on jam in the flat, and both teams grab some points.
Yep, no lead jammer in this game, so it's going to go the full 2 minutes. We got about 24 more seconds left in the jam as both jammers are scoring. Bella Moy hung up around the top of the track, is able to get around. Beautiful Deadly, a little bit easier for her. She grabs another five, looks like 4 points for Beautiful Deadly.
That's the end of the jam. That's the kind of jam that'll tire someone out.
Yeah, right there at the end of the jam, Mob City lost number 12, Justifiable Homicide, to the penalty box. So it's going to be two blockers only on the track for Mob City against all four of the Reservoir Dolls.
A huge disadvantage. Bashful Babe on the line, number 1-1 for Emerald City.
And Just Daisy jamming for Mob City.
Pile up in the back wall. Just Daisy finding it just difficult. And Reservoir Dolls grab that lead jammer position with number 1-1.
Yeah, that's Bashful Babe. She's the lead jammer for Reservoir Dolls. Just Daisy just now breaking out of the pack as Bashful Babe goes through and scores 5 points.
Huge advantage having those blockers up front.
Yeah, absolutely. And so we just saw Moose and Deathwish go, respectively, for their teams go to the penalty box. And now the Mob City coach has called a team timeout.
Probably a good time to shift up the pace, call the timeout, and try to regroup just a little bit.
Yeah, so at least we have both teams have both jammers, one blocker down for each team, as Mob City seems to be regrouping here. We don't have the huge deficit that we did at the beginning. So after 9 jams, we've got Emerald City, Reservoir Doll sitting at 62, Evergreen at 32. It's still quite a sizable lead, but they have eaten up a lot of that distance from when it was 9-44 or whatever.
It's a big lead, but just about anything can happen, especially in a junior roller derby.
Oh yeah, absolutely. I think that it's reasonably unpredictable. So we've got Kieran up there jamming again for Mob City.
Once again, that's Beautiful Deadly on the line for the Dolls.
Yeah, Beautiful did some good work for him there earlier. Kieran dancing around on the back, trying to flip things up a little bit as the lineup has taken up to the pivot line. We'll see if that helps.
Equal power in the blocker world, but it looks like Deadly will be your lead jammer for the Reservoir Dolls. That's number 5-7.
Absolutely, but with a nice spin move, Kieran is also able to get out.
A 0-0 gain on that jam, a little defensive offense played by the Dolls.
Yeah, that number 18, Candy Camaro, took a big hit when Beautiful Deadly crashed into that pack, but it was 100% legal. But she's definitely going to be feeling that one for a while.
Psychotic Angel back on the line for the Dolls.
All Sum jamming again for Mob City. Tries to go to the outside, now back into the inside as Psychotic Angel gets pushed out of bounds and drug all the way back. All Sum out of the front, and he is the lead jammer for Mob City.
He is already rejoining the pack after his initial pass.
And All Sum in for a scoring pass. He puts all 5 points on the board.
Whilst Angel is still fighting that green wall.
Oh, she ends up scoring herself a forearm penalty, and that's going to send a Psychotic Angel to the penalty box, and we're going to have a power jam here for All Sum and the Mob City Misfits.
Reservoir Dolls also have lost their pivot to the penalty box.
All Sum with a nice jump there, gets over, and oh, the Reservoir Dolls loses another blocker.
I think that's Speedy Peaches.
It is Speedy Peaches, and she's headed to the penalty box to meet up with her cohorts there. I don't know if she's going to get... No, I thought maybe she was going to get called off, but she isn't. Two blockers and one jammer in the penalty box right now for the Reservoir Dolls. So it's going to be a power start, turbocharged, wearing the star for the Mob City Misfits in green.
And turbocharged indeed, and a great advantage to not have your full crew out there.
Yeah, the shoe's on the other foot with two blockers for the Reservoir Dolls.
Turbocharged grabs that lead jammer status with ease.
Yep, no problem for him. In the meantime, we have Psychotic Angel out of the penalty box, but she's going back in. I'm guessing maybe that she got an illegal procedure call, and that has put her in. Now she's put the star on her helmet, and she's going to be sitting in the box with that on it. In the meantime, we've got Turbocharged, and he is just racking up 5 points at a time.
And the Dolls try for some strategy that leads Peaches back to the box again.
Yep, she got an illegal procedure call as well.
Back in the game is the jammer for the Reservoir Dolls. That's number 1-3, Psychotic Angel.
Yep, Psychotic Angel's out on her initial pass. Their number 17, Turbocharged, sees it, calls off the jam, scores 4 points, but not until Psychotic Angel can put two on the board for the Reservoir Dolls.
Great jam for the Mob City.
Yeah, that's exactly what they needed. They've cleaned that deficit up quite a bit, 56 for Evergreen's Mob City and 65 for Emerald City's Reservoir Dogs.
Definitely a defendable lead if Emerald City focuses up here, but we're only at 9 points right now. We were at over 30 not that long ago.
Yeah, jamming for the Reservoir Dolls. Beautiful Deadly gets pushed out of bounds a couple of times already, but she's able to recover and get the lead. Yeah, we've got Kieran out there, and he's in the lead, but not the lead jammer. So Beautiful Deadly calls it off after she fell down. She lost a little bit of her momentum there.
She lost her momentum with a little jam on jam. Slow down the progress of her opponent, but very smart for her to call that off before he got any traction.
Yeah, absolutely. So we've got All Sum out here, and he's going to be jamming for the Mob City.
While Bashful Babe, is back on the line for the Reservoir Dolls, she finds a hole almost immediately, and she is your lead jammer.
Yeah, but All Sum is right behind her. We'll see what ends up happening as the Reservoir Dogs not necessarily speeding the pack up. Bashful Babe hits, neither team able to score.
Good time management by the Dolls right now. That's what they need. They need to control the clock going into halftime.
Yeah, so Mob City looks like they want to get control of the front of that pack, which is what they're doing. They're grabbing the front line up closer to the pivot line as they field number 17, Turbocharged, and they were very successful with him a few jams back where he got some power jams and was able to put up a bunch of points. So Turbocharged jamming for Mob City, but the jammer there for the Reservoir Dolls was able to slide through. She gets the lead.
Speedy Peaches did have Turbocharged's number and slowed him down just enough to let her jammer through. Now they string out the pack and it's called off.
Again, no points scored by either team on that jam.
Bashful Bay back on the line for the Reservoir Dolls.
And we've got Kieran wearing the star for Mob City. All right, so looks like Slam Shady had a false start warning. She was able to yield and stay in the game.
A very fast pack at the beginning there has stalled out on that third turn.
Yeah, well, Bashful Babe out for lead, and she's able to go in there, slide in backwards. Still not get any points, though. That's another jam that's going to end in 0-0.
It's a strategy shutdown. Death Wish on the line now for Reservoir Dolls.
And Just Daisy's going to give it a shot for Mob City. Packs have been lining up at the pivot line.
Reservoir Dolls coach Genesis O'Sin having some words with the official, but now we're back to skate action. Number 253 for Mob City grabs that lead jammer status.
Yeah, that's Just Daisy. She is around and she's got lead jammer, and now she's in on a scoring pass.
While Death Wish is recycled and resets her strategy into that green wall.
Just Daisy out on her first scoring pass, and she picks up 4 points. Deathwish in the back of that pack, still not getting any traction. Just Daisy throwing a little jammer on jammer, blocking in there before turning around and scoring a bunch of points. But she gets pushed out of bounds on the inside, decides to call off the jam. Puts 3 more on the board for Mob City, and that's going to take us within 2 points.
We have a game here, 2-point game between Evergreen and Emerald. Bashful Babe on the line for the Reservoir Dolls.
And Turbocharged wearing the star for Mob City. We've got a clear penalty box. Both teams up to full strength.
I love to see that.
As Turbocharged jockeys around in the back, seeing if he can find a place where a hole's going to be. Tries the outside. Not working, cuts to the inside. That's not working either. Bashful Babe is pushing on the top of the four wall. Oh, and there he goes around the outside. And that's going to be lead jammer status for number 17, Turbocharged. Bashful Babe finally able to break out of the pack on her initial pass. Psychotic Angel going to the penalty box as Turbocharged goes through and picks up 5 points. On her first scoring pass, Bashful Babe, she goes through. She picks up 4 points on her own.
Bashful Babe biding her time, waiting for this gentleman to call it off, and he does.
Yes, he does, and now we've got a lead change. So Emerald's Reservoir Dolls is now, for the first time, not leading in this game as the Mob City Misfits are up 72-69 with just under 7 minutes left to go in the first period of play.
Beautiful Deadly back on the line there for the Dolls, hoping to reverse what happened in a lot that last jam.
And we've got Kieran jamming for Mob City. Both jammers try to slide through the same hole, unable to do it. Kieran sees a lane on the outside, cuts back to the inside, back to the outside. Beautiful Deadly out front.
She is your lead jammer. That's Beautiful Deadly for the Dolls after fighting through that stretched out pack.
Yeah, it looked like Kieran was going to be able to get through, and then he just started fighting and was not able. Finally, just out on his initial pass as Beautiful Deadly on her scoring pass decides to call the jam off when she looks back and sees Kieran approaching.
Grabbing a couple of points, just enough to even out that change. We're at a one-point game.
So, and again, we've got both teams lining up on the pivot line.
And once again, Bashful Babe, number 11, on the line for the Reservoir Dolls.
And we're going to see, is that Awesome out there? Yeah, that yeah. is. Awesome is jamming for... Oh, but Awesome cuts the track.
Almost immediately.
Yeah, he goes to the penalty box, and Bashful Babe's going to have herself a power jam.
Bashful encountering that green wall. She's setting the pace. She gets through and grabs five to reverse that score reversal that we saw before. '76-72 right now, a four-point game. Five more for the Reservoir Dolls.
Deathwish heading to the penalty box one more time for Reservoir Dolls. Awesome back in the game now, but Bashful Babe calls off the jam, even though he had not completed his initial pass yet.
Psychotic Angel having a little bit of penalty trouble, but she is an effective jammer, and that's where she is right now, on the line for Reservoir Dolls.
We got Turbocharged jamming for Mob City.
Back out in the pack is Speedy Peaches. I would not want to encounter her. She is amazing. Speed and effective.
Well, she's back there helping her other blockers hold back Awesome,
allowing their jammer number 13 to grab that lead jammer spot.
And number 8 Hard Candy goes to the box one more time for Mob City. Now Gallifrey to the penalty box for the Reservoir Dolls.
Angel grabs a couple more, calls it off, increasing that lead back to 85-72 in favor of Emerald City.
So is that Tipsy Terror out there for the Reservoir Dolls?
Sure
with all
the
red hair where you can't see her number? you can see her on your screen from the sideways. But for the for Mob City, we've got Kieran out there, and he made it through, and he is your lead jammer.
Terror also through her initial pass, but she is not your lead jammer.
Pack's moving really fast. Kieran moves up and see if he can score some points here. Is able to do it with a good spin move around the inside. Tipsy Terror now also on her scoring pass.
Gallifrey crushes number 4-6 from Mob City.
Kieran puts up some more points on the board and decides to call off the jam before Tipsy Terror can hit the pack again.
And Emerald City is back to a 9-point lead. It's about where we were about a minute ago.
Yeah, this has been a very close, tight game here. You know, Mob City was able to meet that deficit after quite a hard-fought battle. But Emerald City has gotten back all of those points and then some. So we've got Bellamoy jamming for Mob City.
Once again, that's Bashful Babe on the line for Emerald City.
Bashful Babe with some fancy footwork up there in the front of that pack. She's able to get out for lead jammer.
They got to let her go.
Bellamoy, oh, gets a penalty. And she's being sent to the penalty box. So we're going to have a power jam here for the Reservoir Dolls.
Another potential plot point in this game right here as this half winds down. Just over a minute to go. A power jam for the Reservoir Dolls. While the rest of both teams are at full force, there is only one jammer out there. And she just grabbed five more for the Reservoir Dolls.
Yeah, Bashful Babe has definitely turned in a very good performance today for the Dolls. Comes up against Just Daisy, and Just Daisy is like a brick wall up there. She decides that she doesn't want any more of that. Just Daisy goes after their new jammer, knocks her to the inside, but the refs think that that's a clockwise block, so they're going to send her to the penalty box.
Beautiful, deadly, not recycled as they had hoped. Grabs five more. She's your new jammer after the star pass. She can take and receive hits.
Well, we've got Bellamoy back in the game. She's just completed her initial pass, and she is set to score. The star pass is gone there, so she's not going to be able to call off the jam. This thing's going to go all the way. We got another 12 seconds as Bellamoy puts 4 points on the board.
Speedy Peaches finding her way to the penalty box. I didn't see the hit, but I'm sure it was good and worth it.
3 points on the board in that last pass for the Reservoir Dolls. That's going to bring their total score into halftime at 111 to Evergreen's Mob City Misfits 84.
We are at halftime in this amazing Junior League jam off.
All right, and we will be back here and see you folks in just under 15 minutes. All right, everybody, we are back to this game between the Evergreen Mob City Misfits and the Emerald City Junior Gems Reservoir Dolls. And let's recap what we saw in the first half of this game. I think that in the beginning, the Reservoir Dogs had a commanding lead at one point. I believe that the score was 9-44 or 46. And then on a couple of power jams, the Misfits were able to come back up and actually take the lead at one point in time. And but that was short-lived as the Reservoir Dolls were able to come back and making a couple of power jams of their own, they were able to come back and bring the score up. So what we're sitting at here after halftime is the Reservoir Dolls 111 and the Evergreen Mob City Misfits at 84.
Yeah, there's some great players on both sides. Definitely there's some defensive players that made a huge difference in the second part of that first half. Players like Speedy Peaches on the doll side were just running down and squeegeeing out the jammers from the other side, and it's made a huge difference in both directions. The defensives played a huge role in this.
Yep, no, you have to have good defense there. If you can't stop the opposing jammer from getting out, you know, you can't get your jammer out there to score. But there were quite a few 0-0 jams as well.
Yeah, so, a lot of the shutdown. The Emerald City seems to use that as their main tactic. Speed it up and shut it down.
Yeah, if you can do it. So we've got the track here. Clock's halftime's winding down. Out here during halftime, we saw some of the junior Team USA skaters out here warming up, getting ready to play in their big game that I believe is coming up on this track after we're done here.
I think the MVP from Emerald that's going into that is Beautiful Deadly. She just got told they're having their equipment check right now, safety checks.
That's so Beautiful Deadly will get to play two games back-to-back, I guess, then, huh?
She doesn't seem phased.
I don't think it'll bother her one bit.
She's a real soldier. And will probably matriculate into the Emerald City League in the next few years.
Yeah, she's definitely done a great job out here today, Beautiful Deadly, getting on the track right now, but maybe she isn't.
The star is still up for grabs here on the Emerald City side, but Kieran is on the line for Mob City currently.
Yeah, they're going to start up there. Oh, and there's Bashful Babe. She's got the star on, and she's going to be jamming for Reservoir Dolls.
For a second there, it looked like Genesis of Sin, Coach Jennifer, was throwing up the timeout sign. But we are in gameplay. Number 1-1 jamming for the Reservoir Dolls is already breaking through that green wall and grabbing our lead jammer status.
Yeah, Kieran not having any luck at all getting around that defense. Now he finally finds an opening, is able to shoot through. Kieran out on his initial pass as Bashful Babe thinks about calling it off, but then says, "Nah, you know what, I'm going to try to grab a couple more points." She does, 4 points for Bashful Babe.
Good jammer-to-jammer awareness there. That's a super important skill to learn. Know where your other jammer is when you're jamming. Know when to call it off. Know when to hold them, know when to fold them, I guess.
That is what they say. Well, we've got Awesome out there, and he's going to be jamming for the Mob City Misfits.
While Psychotic Angel out there on the line again for the Dolls.
Oh, Psychotic Angel finds a great big hole around the outside. Psychotic Angel out to be lead jammer.
Almost immediately scooching through that right side hole while the jammer for Mob City is still struggling with that front wall.
Yeah, Awesome not able to get out yet. He's got Beautiful Deadly to beat. Can he do it? Yep, he finally does. Gets out on his initial pass.
Jam is called off, but not before 4 more points are posted for Emerald City. Bashful Babe on the line again for the Reservoir Dolls.
Yeah, well, they're going to start up on the pivot line like they've been doing. And as soon as I was going to make a comment and ask about that and see what your opinion was, they move back and to the jammer line. And the game gets started there as Kieran is jamming for Mob City. One more blocker to beat. Is he able to do it? Yeah, he is. Kieran out, and he's the lead jammer for Mob City. But right behind him is Bashful Babe.
It looked like almost like they found the same hole. And got through it.
Sometimes that happens. We'll see if Mob City can keep Bashful Babe from scoring. And she's able to pick up 1 point to Kieran's 2 points.
Chiseling away at that lead difference. Psychotic Angel now on the line for the Reservoir Dolls. She's been on that line a lot. She's also been in the penalty box a little bit too. We're not sure if she's in trouble yet.
So we have both teams lining up closer to the pivot line this time as the whistle blows. Both jammers heading towards it kind of slowly. But there's Psychotic Angel with those great footwork and moves around the front. She grabs lead jammer.
With authority and with speed, she's your lead jammer.
Turbocharged finally makes his way through.
Angel with a little blocking as she comes through, yeah, blocks for herself.
Psychotic Angel puts a big hit on Just Daisy to give herself that opening that she needs to fly through and score the last points that she needed on that pass. Puts four more up for Reservoir Dolls.
This next generation of skaters will need to be blockers and jammers all in one. That's sort of the way the roller derby is going right now. You have to be able to take and give blocks if you're going to be a jammer. You can't just be fast and smooth anymore.
Well, that's for sure. Bella Moy being both fast and smooth for the Mob City Misfits, but not fast enough or smooth enough, as we have Deathwish in there grabbing lead jammer for Reservoir Dolls.
And Bella finally finding her way through and fighting a little jam on jam against Deathwish. Unable to grab any points.
Yeah, Deathwish actually gets her point there. She's puts five on the board during that jam.
Angel on the line again. Psychotic Angel for the Dolls.
Also wearing the star for Mob City. Psychotic Angel steps through her line, finds a hole on the inside. Awesome follows her. Oh, no, he doesn't. He gets a forearm as he tries to follow her out and gets to the penalty box. So this is going to give
great advantage to the Dolls right now.
Absolutely.
Two to beat up front. Can Angel do it? She does. She strings them out. They got to let her go. She grabs five more for the Reservoir Dolls.
Yeah,
beautiful,
so
beautiful deadly being called to the penalty box.
Multiplayer block there is going to take her out. And another 5 points for Psychotic Angel as she goes around. Awesome out of the penalty box.
Having to contend with the Reservoir Dolls crew.
Awesome out of his initial pass and ready to score. Let's see what Psychotic Angel does.
She was quite aware that he was approaching the backpack and calls off the jam, grabs two more points for Eugene.
2-2 on that jam.
Bashful Babe. Back out on the jam line for Eugene.
And Kieran again for Mob City.
Bashful Babe scooching to the forward pack.
She goes down. Kieran has passed her a little bit as she's kind of stuck at the back. Kieran falls as well.
Babe is pushed out of line.
And Kieran with the spin move gets out. A little whip assist there. Gets Bashful Babe out as well.
It's a beautiful cooperation by both teams there inside the pack. Communication and cooperation.
Kieran spins and goes through. Calls off the jam. Picks up all four of his points and holds the Reservoir Dogs to zero on that pass.
Deathwish back on the line for the Reservoir Dolls.
And we're going to see Turbo Charged for Mob City.
So wall change up front in the pack as the Reservoir Dolls crew prepares for that opposing jammer to come through.
Yep, Turbo Charge battling up against Peaches up in front, was finally able to juke her and get around, so he's going to be going to lead jammer, and we just got Deathwish as out as well.
While both teams lose blockers to the penalty box.
Both teams on their scoring pass. We got a forearm that's going to take Moose out. She's going to be headed to the penalty box for Mob City as Deathwish goes through on her scoring pass, grabs four also for Turbo Charge. turbocharged with less blockers to beat there. Is able to pick up 4 points. Scoring also is Death Wish. Right now she's passed out of bounds, or pushed out of bounds on the inside. Gets recycled to the back. Turbocharged up through, faces off against the two wall. One more blocker to beat, is able to jump up and get around to grab all 4 points in that jam. We see a star pass over here. And
our pivot becomes our jammer for the Reservoir Dolls.
Yeah, that's number 33, Slam Shady.
Well, the real Slam Shady, please stand up and try to score some points here. 149, Bashful Babe back on the line for Reservoir Dolls.
So the Reservoir Dolls have done a good job at regaining the lead that they had early on in this game.
Attacking that pack head on, thanks to a lot of defense too.
Just Daisy jamming from Ob City. Just Daisy up around. She's headed out first. Can she make it? Yes, she does. Just Daisy is the lead jammer, but there's Bashful Babe right behind her. Just Daisy trying to put a little hit on her. Knocks her out of bounds, but goes out of bounds herself. Decides to call off the jam from the floor because she knew Bashful Babe was going to turn on the afterburners and get up there and score some points.
Bashful Babe was still on all eight wheels and ready to score. Smart move.
Yeah, a lot easier to score on all eight wheels than it is from laying on your back, right?
That's a good point. That's number 44 again on the line for the Eugene team. That's Tipsy Terror.
Yeah, she seems like she's a good sort of reliever jammer in there, and she's put up some points on the board on her own. Kieran jamming once again for Mob City. He's actually up in front, pushing his way through, but loses his balance and goes down but not out. So he's out of the pack, and he is the lead jammer. We've got a multiplayer block in the meantime, and that's going to take out Mob City player number 46. And that's Izzy X.
Kieran has done this wiggle his way to the front thing a few times.
He has indeed.
Has been effective against the defense here today.
Yeah, big pile up though, and I think it was Reservoir Doll v. Reservoir Doll there, but either way, number 44, Tipsy Terror gets out off of her initial pass, and so Kieran decides he wants to call that thing off before she goes around there and puts some points on the board for Reservoir Dolls.
The Dolls coach, that's Coach Jennifer, is out in the middle with the words for officials, I'm pretty sure. And the coach for Mob City also is coming face to face with an official right there in the middle of the track.
Yeah, that's calling the shots out there, and I don't think he's going to be listening to too much guff from any of those folks unless they start calling the official or the timeouts or official reviews. Ooh, but a multiplayer block is going to take out number 11, Bashful Babe. You don't see that too often from a jammer, but every once in a while she'll grab on to one of her teammates for a whip or an assist and end up getting that multiplayer block if somebody tries to challenge that link. So she's going to be in the penalty box as number 17, turbocharged, goes around, gets pushed out of bounds there and has to get recycled. That's number 13, Psychotic Angel, jumping around back there, making sure that he goes back far enough. Pushed out again, lost his balance, but he thinks Psychotic Angel went out of bounds. But Mike Hammer, the outside pack ref, did not think that she went out of bounds, and so he sent Turbocharge to the penalty box. In the meantime, Bashful Babe, she's out of the penalty box, and she is hitting the pack up in front there, confronting just Daisy and number 46, Izzy X up at the front. Ends up getting out on her scoring pass, 5 points.
A great turn of events if you are a Reservoir Doll right there. From what we could see, that could have gone either direction. Both jammers were being squeezed out, and it landed in favor of the Dolls.
That definitely did, and she squeezed out 10 points, and she's going to see if she can get 5 more on the board. There's 15.
Turbo Charge being recycled for the fourth time in this jam.
Yeah, well, Psychotic Angel ended up getting her comeuppance on this jam as she gets to go to the penalty box. We have what I believe is a team timeout being called by Mob City.
Mob City calling this timeout to regroup and possibly to change up the tempo here, as it hasn't been in their favor in the last 5 or 6 jams.
Yeah, they've had, I think, a little bit of desperation moves in there by a couple of their jammers, where they really knew that they needed to get out and get that lead. And when they weren't able to do it, a little bit of reckless play ensued. And I think that that's one of the things that landed Turbocharged in the box there.
I think that's probably some of the words that are coming right out of that coach's mouth right now.
Well, I may have used a couple of those words with my team as well during a similar type of a situation in the past. So I know what it's like to be on that sideline and to be talking to a team that is a good team. Obviously, they're a great team. They're here. They're really holding their own. But they're just having a little bit of trouble, you know, keeping it together. This the Reservoir Dolls team is definitely a force to be reckoned with. And I mean, they've got so many weapons. They've got Deathwish, Bashful Babe, Psychotic Angel, you know, blocking wise out there. Just some amazing
Gallifrey.
Gallifrey. I mean, there's so many awesome players out there.
That's Deathwish. Speaking of Deathwish, grabbing that lead jammer status from Kieran right off the onset there.
Yep, she calls it off. He's able to get out. She puts 2 points on the board. But
what you were saying about the sort of the balance between that controlled aggression and staying with a plan.
Sure.
Is always, in a full contact sport, that's always sort of the balance you have to keep.
Oh, yeah, but I mean, you know, and you know, talk about good players, though, too. I mean, Mob City's got out here on the line right now, Just Daisy. I mean, she is an excellent jammer. She's an excellent blocker. Just Daisy's been putting up a great game. It just seems like the breaks are not going their way. She gets pushed out of bounds, recycled around the inside. In the meantime, Bashful Babe gets out and easily attains lead. Here goes Just Daisy. She's out on her initial pass. Bashful Babe getting some offense in there from Psychotic Angel, but Psychotic Angel goes to the penalty box again, and she might be getting into penalty trouble.
My count could be wrong, but that's either 4 or 5 for her. Death Wish again on the line for the Eugene ladies. My favorite part about watching juniors is how they're not tired.
No, they're not. They're not fazed by the physicality of this game whatsoever.
The focus is still there at minute 13 and minute 45.
That's right, and you see some focus in the eyes of Deathwish as she goes around, picks up lead jammer. Poor Kieran, he just keeps getting pushed out and getting recycled the whole time. Deathwish, it's her turn to get recycled around there. Like I said, Mob City has some great players. Moose pushes her out of bounds and takes her all the way back. Kieran having a hard time getting up and getting his balance as there's a big collision in the front. Track cut is going to end up taking Deathwish out, and so we're going to see Kieran if he can work on this jam here by himself, score some points. But Gallifrey is up there giving him the business.
Gallifrey is one of these people we're going to see in the adult leagues without a doubt. She's an intense, focused player.
Yeah, and Speedy Peaches is just up there, and she has been a stalwart in the top of, I don't know, I thought that was Speedy Peaches, is it?
No, it's not,
number
actually. Eight,
number that's, 83. No, yeah.
Bomegranate.
Bomegranate, yeah, man. She's out there putting up the huge defense.
Deathwish back in play after being strung back by the pivot from the opposing side.
She goes down. I see another track cut is in her future as she ends up heading back to the penalty box.
That's Angel.
Oh, it's Psychotic
and Deathwish.
Yep, Psychotic Angel and Deathwish.
Right now we have one of our best blockers, the pivot, and the jammer for the Dolls sitting on the bench. And this could be danger for them.
Well, Kieran is going to end up this jam. And it looks like some sort of a destruction call or something is going to send Moose to the penalty box.
I see a review in our future. I can feel it in my bones.
Well, at least a team timeout being called by the Dolls. And that's good because, you know, I think that, you know, they definitely have a commanding lead here and they need to keep it. They want to do whatever they can to slow the momentum down here as Mob City is going to be able to capitalize on the fact that they've got Psychotic Angel, one of their best blockers and jammers, in the box. And yeah, so she's going out. I thought that she was probably in penalty trouble earlier, and I was right. The last couple that she got ended up taking her out of the game. So Psychotic Angel has fouled out for Reservoir Dolls. And it looks like number 57, Beautiful Deadly, is going to take her place in the penalty box.
When I see those non-skating officials walk over to coaches, I just usually know that we'll be sitting here for a second. Here comes our head ref. He might have words.
Yeah, I think he's verifying with the lineup trackers that she is indeed fouled out of the game. Okay, and he's got a clockwise block and going to Gallifrey and an additional insubordination because she did not report to the penalty box. So Gallifrey is going to be sitting in the penalty box for a full minute, and she's probably getting close to being into penalty trouble too herself with those two additional penalties.
There's no doubt that she is. Having to click off like that is not positive for them. That's not positive for the Dolls in general. She is a multi-faceted player.
So Bellamoy now jamming for Mob City, jumps in, grabs lead real quick, and we've got Deathwish in there, hot on her heels.
Speedy Peach is out there handling the crowd by herself. Beautiful Deadly with a huge hit on the jammer.
Yeah, Beautiful Deadly just slided right in front of Bella Moy as she was going full blast, and it knocked her down. It was she had a little hard time getting up there. She got her bell rung pretty good, but back up and at it and in the game, getting recycled right now, decides to call it off.
And amidst that chaos, 4 points still grabbed up by both teams.
Yeah, no, absolutely. The jammers here for the Reservoir Dolls are obviously very, very smart, seasoned jammers, and they know exactly when to call it off and when to push for some more points. I think had Bellamoy not taken that big knockdown, she may have called it off a little bit earlier. So
yeah, that could make you rethink what you're doing.
Yep.
On the line right now for the Reservoir Dolls. Again, that's Bashful Babe.
Yeah, Bashful Babe, another jammer that's turned in a very good game here so far for the Reservoir Dolls. And then we've got Turbocharged. He's a go-to jammer for the Mob City Misfits. And he's giving it the old college try, but just not able to produce, unfortunately. There goes Bashful Babe, racking up lead jammer status for the Reservoir Dolls.
As she does, she's making it look easy again.
Yeah, definitely not, because Mob City has a great defense. They're putting the defense onto her right now, actually forcing her to call it off, giving Turbocharge time to get around. So,
three more points being thrown up. And although we're getting near the end of this bout, and there's a little bit of a score difference, it could go either way at any time. Any kind of plot point change could happen.
Well, I think the more of the more penalties that any of the Reservoir Dolls rack up are going to be very detrimental to their game. So yeah, with still almost just a little under 10 minutes left in this game, the lead isn't high enough to be too comfortable now for Reservoir Dolls, especially with just Daisy out there, because if she can get some traction, she's definitely a good jammer. Both teams up to full strength, neither team with any blockers in the penalty box right now. We've got just Daisy, and she's going to be facing off against Death Wish. Evergreen's Mob City has the back line of this pack sewn up. They're ready to engage. Unfortunately, the officials are going to continue this official timeout here a little bit longer, verifying, I'm sure, that you know the score is all correct and the number of penalties is all correct. They're you can see them putting the eagle eye of the NSO on the penalty board, and they're looking at that and they're making sure that all the penalties are adding up correctly.
Like you said, it can make a huge difference here in the game. The Reservoir Dolls do rely on their multifaceted players so much. Right now, Deathwish on the line, she's been known to give and take just as many hits, even when she's got the star on her helmet, and find those holes no matter where they are. I think it's smart of them to have that back wall to give her a, sort of a pump the brakes even before she can get any kind of speed. She is known for finding holes like nobody.
Yeah, well, it just at this point in time, the difference is going to go down to the speed, right? So if she can figure out how to get speedy there and be able to put a move on one of those blockers that's on the outside, she'll be able to jump up and grab lead. Because you know they're going to let Just Daisy go through very quickly, and she's going to have to face off, you know, against a very tough defensive wall up there in the front. If they continue with this type of lineup, you know, I see Beautiful Deadly up there, and she's going to try to catch Just Daisy and probably push her out of bounds on the inside if she possibly can. So
Beautiful Deadly, she has this chase and race mentality, where if she's playing pivot, she'll speed up the pack to slow you down.
Yeah, Just Deadly obviously has command of this game very well. So, okay, we're ready to go. The jam has started. Just Daisy, as I predicted, was easily able to get through, and she was also able to jump up grad lead jammer. That back wall did take care of Death Wish. Just Daisy goes around and puts a big hit on an inverted blocker, taking her down. In the meantime, Kieran goes to the penalty box, and around goes Just Daisy on her scoring pass. Death Wish gets a penalty there. She grabs a high block, and that's going to put Just Daisy and the Mob City Misfits on a power jam. This is their opportunity to crush that deficit that we were talking about during the break.
It's a huge moment for them right here, as time management becomes just as important as scoring points.
Yeah, and Just Daisy took a huge hit there from, I believe that was number 16. but I don't see a 16 on the roster. Maybe I was mistaken. I was looking up. I was looking at just Daisy to make sure that she was getting up. And then, oh, yeah, there is number 16 right there, Juke Skywalker. He is the blocker for Reservoir Dolls that just put a huge smacking on just Daisy. I have a feeling the referees are discussing that hit right now, possibly.
From what I saw, it was clean, but possibly still beyond the realm of in the rules.
Well, what I can't, I don't know whether it was or not, but what I can tell you is that no penalty was called at the time. We're using up a team, an official review, a Reservoir Dolls official review. So they're reviewing something. So it was probably not the hit on Juke Skywalker, as a matter of fact, because they wouldn't review their own hit, would they?
Right. We need to thank Blaze Media for helping us with this streaming this whole weekend. Blaze Media is there when you need them. Also, the official beer of the Emerald City Roller Girls is Ninkasi, and they throw down money to help out with this media stuff every single time we do this. So thanks to Ninkasi Brewing. They make a heck of a beer.
So entertaining the crowd there now, I believe that is Little Boomerang, and she's doing some handstands to keep everybody entertained during this official review.
Almost entertaining enough are those fuzzy leg warmers.
Yeah, I've been trying to avoid looking at those. They'll
mesmerize you.
Well, those are super distracting out there, to be honest with you, on the track. You know, and I tell, I kind of try to keep my team, uniform so that, specific jammers or specific blockers don't stick out and can get targeted. But this is the other way around. This is, those things are so distracting that it's hard not to look at them.
It's true. We're still having an extended discussion over there by the officials, while the young ladies get to know each other better on the pivot line.
Yeah, absolutely. Whatever issue the Reservoir Dolls staff brought to the attention. Was definitely enough to keep them busy for a while. I wonder if we can find out what it is or if it'll remain a mystery.
Sitting at just over 8.5 minutes, there's still a bit of a deficit for the Evergreen team. They were at 179-146 to Emerald City.
So I'm going to make some predictions that may or may not be true, but I don't see anything changing, right? So I don't see the score changing.
Waiting to hear from the officials what happened there.
Oh, okay.
Doesn't seem to have affected the score at all.
Yeah, so if we do hear what the review is about, that would definitely be helpful. That'll avoid me trying to guess. But, I'm here behind the microphone, not affecting the gameplay. So whether I guess correctly or not, it's not going to make any difference. Okay, so they are out there, and they are talking to Just Daisy. Okay, so my prediction is going to be that Just Daisy committed a penalty and is being sent to the penalty box.
Not what I expected, actually.
Well, Colin Deschatz asked her to stand up now. And talking to the Mob City coach, Just Daisy is now sitting down with the star on her helmet, so that would tell me that the penalty was committed by her while she was the jammer in this past jam.
both jammers may be starting in the box.
Both jammers may be starting in the box, but
that's what it looks like.
Yeah, well, we've got Deathwish, and she's going to be standing, so she's going to have less than 10 seconds. So she will be released. All right, well, they're still explaining what's going on over there. So there's it's whatever the issue was definitely not an obvious issue.
The coach for Mob City needing more explanation.
Okay, so somebody from the medical staff now is interviewing Just Daisy.
I have a feeling we won't move forward until this part is assessed by this medical team.
Yeah, agreed. Okay, here we go. Hang on, folks. Calling the shots is telling us what's going on. Okay, so we were substantially correct. She did obtain a penalty in that last jam. I don't recall if Colin the Shot said what it was. Do you recall if he mentioned what the penalty was for? No. And then the medical staff was assessing Just Daisy to because she hit her head a little bit, wanted to make sure that she didn't have a concussion. So, as I said, the jam whistle blew. Deathwish was released. Just Daisy now being released. Deathwish out, gets lead jammer very quickly. Just Daisy clears the pack also very quickly. And Deathwish in the pack on her scoring pass calls off the jam after scoring one additional point.
This is the time in this kind of bout where clock management becomes very important. Who will hold that lead jammer status? Who will be able to call it off? Because any kind of big upset here could change the score really quick.
Yeah, it looks like Reservoir Dolls have two of their timeouts remaining, Mob City with one. And Turbocharged out there jamming for Mob City gets knocked down, but at the same time around on the other side, we've got Bashful Babe going around picking up lead jammer. Now playing some defense and attempting to drag her back is Turbocharged. That wasn't successful. He tries it again, also goes out of bounds again.
Turbocharged with the big hits, knocks himself out of play.
Yep, those hits have to be controlled. If you take yourself out of play, it doesn't really make any difference.
It's the kind of call that we have our officials for, because they would just keep skating.
All right, so Just Daisy, not only is she well enough to play, but she's jamming again. So the medics have given her a clean bill of health, and she is out there. Now, Reservoir Dolls can't figure out who they want to jam. So the star has passed to the third player so far. And now we've got Beautiful Deadly out there wearing it. And she's going to jump and juke around and see if she can grab lead for her team. But she is unsuccessful, and Just Daisy is out for lead. Beautiful Deadly getting pushed out of bounds on the outside and drug back. We've got a track cut. The track cut is going to Beautiful Deadly. She's going to the penalty box. A Just Daisy on a power jam. She is hit down in the middle of the track, but not out. Gets up and continues power jamming. She's able to slide around on the outside past Little Boom Harang. And she is out. She scores 5 points. Just Daisy again jukes around, unhit that time as she goes through.
Reservoir Dolls regrouping and figuring out how they're going to handle this. Daisy coming back through again.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you how they're going to handle it. They're going to handle it by getting Beautiful Deadly out there and through the pack, which she just did. Jam is called. One additional point for Just Daisy and Mob City there. That's going to bring the total up to 157 points for Mob City and 183 for the Reservoir Dolls. Just over 5 minutes left in this game.
Coach Jennifer rethinking the strategy. Good shot of her there, deep in thought. Bashful Babe now on the line for Reservoir Dolls.
Kieran fans out there are rooting for him as he's going to try to get lead jammer here. Loses his balance in the back. Bashful Babe up in front, two blockers to beat now. Three gets sucked back a little bit, not too bad. Bashful Babe but backwards skating, gets out. She gets lead jam. Little Boomerang goes up to the front of the pack to join her blockers in front to keep Kieran back, but they are not able to do so. He gets out, and the jam gets called off by Bashful Babe, 0-0.
Good strategy there for Emerald City.
No points, but it did eat some time off of the clock, and we have an official review being called for by Mob City this time.
Mob City using their official review, not sure for what, but Coach Jennifer is being called to the middle to be part of the cabal. I'm a little bit surprised. Seemed like business as usual that last jam.
Well, they saw on the Mob City side, they saw something that they took issue with.
Well, this is the time to do it, because this is the time to slow down the clock.
Yeah, either way, it's going to give both teams an opportunity to regroup. So Mob City coach is out there talking to the captain, or at least, I guess maybe she's not the captain, but that's Gallifrey out there having a conversation with the Mob City coach out on the track.
I'm not sure what the coach could be saying to opposing player. It's causing a little bit of a moment out there for the ladies as the officials officially review their official review.
Yeah, so I mean, this has been a good game for the Reservoir Dolls. They've been in the lead for a substantial amount of time here. Okay, and so it looks like a Mob City is getting their review erased from the board. So it looks like they are not going to retain it, but I am still not sure what was at issue. But as I was saying, the Reservoir Dolls have been doing a very good, but they're not ahead enough to get comfortable. They want to celebrate, but they can't, because this game is still tenuous here, especially with jammers out there like Just Daisy. We've got Turbocharged on the line, and he hasn't always been successful at getting lead, but when he gets out, he can put some points on the board.
Turbocharged has proven himself effective even as a blocker today.
Turbocharged pushed out of bounds on the outside, gets recycled back behind Gallifrey. In the meantime, Tipsy Terror out in front, but does not get lead, and there goes number 17. Turbocharged, he gets the lead. Tipsy Terror right behind him. See if he can put some points on the board with this lead. Two blockers in the back for Mob City close the door, but are not able to keep Tipsy Terror from getting through.
Tipsy Terror is all the way through.
Yes. Both jammers here in scoring position. So now Tipsy Terror has matched the points that Turbocharge got, and now she's scoring some more. Turbocharged, the lead jammer, still not calling it off. Tipsy Terror doubling the amount of points now. So Mob City eating a bunch of time off the clock, finally calls the jam off after going into what looks like about a 7-point deficit, if my math is correct.
Coach Jennifer coming out to meet with the officials.
Yep, this is an official reviewing game. We've got another official review that is being called, and it's going to be Reservoir Dolls this time.
I think I misspoke before when I said that it was Beautiful Deadly who is in the MVP game. I think it's actually... Hold on.
Well, I can guarantee it's either her or somebody else. One of the two.
This guy. I think it's Tiny Badness, actually, now that I think about it.
Yeah? Awesome. Well, you know,
she's already out with them.
Ah, okay.
I think that's why she's not here.
All right, the official review is still underway. And you can see the refs are all huddled there.
We're at about 3 minutes to go in this game.
Yep, this has been a very well reviewed game,
especially in this last third of it.
When we do come back, we're probably going to see Just Daisy jamming because she's out there wearing the star now. And we're also probably going to see Little Boom Harang take her rainbow colored, what are those, leg warmers?
Distractors.
Rainbow colored distractor skate covers out around the track. And she's going to see if she can confuse Mob City out there. She's flying through the pack with those things on as the jammer.
Emerald City grabbing lead jammer in this jam will be a pivotal moment.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Like I was saying before, I mean, this is a very close game. You know, this is a one power jam game either way. So one power jam can sew this thing up for the Reservoir Dolls. If they get the power jam, they can knock this thing out right now. If the Mob City Misfits get a power jam, they could come back and they could put enough points on the board to win this thing. So that's where we are right now. So the official review has been concluded. We have no idea what happened. Just Daisy is on the line jamming for Mob City. We've got Little Boom Harang out there. And Just Daisy pushing through in the front. Just Daisy is out in front. One blocker to beat. Can she do it? Yes, she is out there, but Little Boom Harang is right behind her. Just Daisy out for lead.
Boomerang with her crossover style, keeping pace.
You'd think that those things would slow her down, but they don't at all. But she does get pushed out of bounds on the outside. Daisy gets up. She gets pushed out of bounds on the inside. Has to be recycled. Both jammers on their scoring passes at this point in time. Little Boom Harang enters the pack as Jay-Z gets recycled all the way back around. Again, Daisy still the lead jammer. Time is ticking off of this clock. She decides to call it off, and let's see the points in the air. 3 for Mob City, 3 for the Reservoir Dolls, and all that jam did was eat a bunch of time off the clock.
Right now it works in the advantage of the leading team.
Absolutely. That didn't, even though they got lead jammer out of it, it didn't end up helping the Mob City Misfits at all. So they're going to try it again. This time, Bashful Babe out there, one of the go-to jammers for the Reservoir Dolls. And then, of course, number 15, Kieran for Mob City. Both jammers hit the back of that pack. Bashful Babe looking for the inside.
Kieran almost grabbing it when Gallifrey st- steps in front of him and recycles him again. She is vicious with that recycle.
And there she goes. Bashful Babe is out, and she is the lead jammer now with under 1 minute to go in this game. We'll see what she ends up doing with this lead. All right, she goes through. Her bench coach is telling her to call it off, but she now looks back and sees her, so she does it. Okay, 2 points goes on the board for Mob City, 3 for the Reservoir Dolls. 30 seconds left to go in the game. Mob City calls a timeout.
Smart move by Mob City. This may be the last jam we see tonight.
Yeah, it may be for a number of different reasons, not just because there's 30 seconds on the game clock, but also because Mob City has used their last team timeout and has lost the review that they had. So Reservoir Dolls can stop the clock with one additional team timeout if they wish. We're going to come to the natural conclusion of this game after 30 seconds or the jam that comes underway now. Little boom harangue, wearing the star again for Reservoir Dolls.
Some smiles coming across the faces of the Emerald City bench.
Yeah, I think that they see a positive outcome in sight, despite the fact that, you know, we're really not in much of a different position than we were the last time for the Power Jam.
They will play hard to the end.
Well, they need to, because this game could still go either direction.
My favorite kind of game.
Turbocharge pushing across the back, and he is not able to get out. And that Gallifrey really holding him back. She has shown her excellent blocking skills in this game.
Both jammers recycled twice there.
Yeah, little boomerang not able to get out. She's got a full floor wall. Oh, we got a direction of an out of play penalty there, and that's going to give Turbocharge exactly what he's looking for. But he's going to need to speed up there and start scoring some points if he wants to make up that deficit. He gets up there, battles off against, and hits the ground, battling off against Gallifrey, able to beat her again. Puts 4 points on the board, no pass, no penalty, as the Reservoir Dolls lose another player to the penalty box.
That's Pomegranate, who has been incredibly effective on that front wall all day.
And out again for a 5-point scoring pass. We've got Turbocharge. The period clock has run out. Little Boomerang has gone to the penalty box as the jammer. We've got 34 seconds left in this game. We've got 5 points going up for Turbocharged. Turbocharged around, still on the Power Jam. He's going to need to speed up if he wants to make enough points. He gets up there, faces off against both of the blockers, ends up going down. Turbocharged back on his feet, back down again, passes the cap to number 11. That's going to be Bella Moy, one of the go-to jammers for Mob City, as she's got 4 more seconds to go. She completes the scoring pass. She puts 5 points on the board for Mob City before the end of the jam. And let's tally up the score and see how close Mob City has gotten. We've got an unofficial final right now of 190 to 197.
An incredible last jam.
They could have
changed everything, and it may have changed everything. Still just an unofficial number on the board.
Yeah, definitely. I'm not sure that there are 7 points at issue, but it certainly still is unofficial at this point in time. And we're going to wait to make sure that it is, because it is definitely one of the closer games that I have seen. Okay, final score. We have the victors, Reservoir Dolls at 197, Mob City at 190. That was a hard-fought game that went down to the last jam.
Fantastic.
Yeah, when Little Boomerang went to the penalty box,
the look on her face.
She was devastated.
Yeah, she was playing it easy and cool.
If Turbocharged would have had a little bit more gas in his engine, he's been working hard for this entire hour, and so when it came down to it, he just couldn't turn it up enough to put another scoring pass on. Finally passes the star to Bellamoy, but still not enough time for her to get around either.
And with the efforts of the blockers from the Eugene team, especially Gallifrey on that last jam.
She was amazing.
She took him down twice.
Yep.
And squeegeed him out the corner a couple times too. That was an incredible last jam.
Yeah, so this is going to end it up. We saw a lot of interesting playing out there. This was a highly reviewed game. All of the teams used all of their official reviews up, won some, lost some. We spent a lot of time on official timeouts. We had a couple of injuries and several foul outs. I think the Reservoir Dolls lost another skater at the end of the game there as well.
Yeah, it was an amazingly exciting ending, but throughout it was a back-and-forth kind of game, and we saw really who is the future of this sport, and that's these ladies that we just watched and men that we just watched that will be the next wave that will definitely prove powerful in the world of roller derby.
All right, well, that's going to do it for us. Stay tuned here to see the juniors, Team USA, take on the MVPs from the Big O tournament.
I'm Pat Trant, signing off.
And I'm Professor D. We'll catch you later.
Thanks so much.